Welcome all. So this is one of the standard discussions in our community. I think every parent would have undergone this kind of a decision making process or a confusion. I think more and more generation parents are getting confused about an important decision in their child's life called as vaccination. Should I really do a vaccination or should I completely ignore them? Or should I do a certain kinds of vaccination and ignore other ones? So these are like constant battle in a parent's head. What do we do? The answer lies here. We need to understand the history of vaccination. So it's going to be a series of video which I'm going to make it, because I don't want to make it long video and make it boring. People might not watch it. I want to make it a short series with some snippets with statistical information, whatever I have learned it, and it's available online. You can read it by yourself. So let's understand where the concept of vaccination comes from. Okay, so vaccination and serums, you need to understand the difference between these two. Okay, so what happens is when you inject a virus into a horse or a donkey, that you are sending the virus into it, so that is like vaccinating it. So once it goes into it, immediately that animal would, the animal's body inside, the immunity system starts working and starts creating poison to kill that virus in their body. So once it produces, it's called antioxin. That's antioxidant, what we call antioxin. Immediately that blood will try to kill it. So what they do is then they collect the blood out of from that animal, and they try to do a certain process about it, like say some processing or distillation or infection, something they do, some process they do it, and they collect the essence of it, the serum. That will be like a milky substance. So that's what they use, the serum. Any disease, if you go, they'll actually inject a serum. It's nothing but an animal's blood, processed it, and later they have known how to artificially create it. So we don't know which one we are using it, and none of the companies would say because of their copyright issue. So that is the fact. Okay, now coming to the vaccination history. How did it all started? When it, from why it has been so practiced now? And even if you know, an experienced doctor would not, even an allopathy doctor would actually will personally tell you don't do it. Whereas the new people would actually say no, do it, it's very important, other things. Now I'll give you some statistics. I'm not an expert, neither a doctor, but whatever I have learned, I'm sharing. You make your informed decision and let's discuss about it, okay? Because we had some really good anti-vax people earlier in our community. They were like really giving the data, and we were not prepared to even know at that point of time. Whatever we know, we wanted it from verification from various people. But now, as we have been constantly learning, I just wanted to share it here. So, in 1729, a lady, a wife of a British ambassador in Turkey, they were there for a long time, and they noticed some kind of a strange phenomena there. What they did was the vaccination process in traditional folks were been following it outside India. Even in India, we had it in a different form, but they were doing it in a different form there, like China, Iran, Iraq, Turkey, all that region, they were doing something. What they were doing is, if somebody gets a smallpox, they will actually go to him, and what they do is they cut one of the boils, the blister there, and they'll take that blood and they will try to add some water and they'll keep it. And what they do is they put a needle and they prick it to all other people, whoever has not got chickenpox. So what they say is, once that minute portion of the virus enters the other person, the normal person's body, immediately his body also will produce that poison, the antioxin, and that scar would remain, and they will not get, because the body has now known, detected the disease, and it knows how to kill it. That is stored in our body. So that means anytime when it comes in future, it knows how to defend itself. So that is the idea when they try to they promote it at that point of time. So what she learned from there, and then she came back to England, and she started telling everyone, like, hey, I have vaccine. My she has done it for her own children's, and it started spreading like a elite kind of treatment. They called this oriental vaccination or some kind of a name. Okay, so only the royal families or only a people, it become to an elite class, they would do a vaccination. In those days, 1730s or 1740s, in that time, doing this smallpox vaccination would cost you 10 sterling, which is very huge amount at that point of time. So then it became, then seeing them, a lot of middle class population people started jumping into it. Yeah, even I want to vaccinate my child, and they started doing it. Then surprisingly, after like they were doing it for almost like 40-50 years, and then they found out like many people who died through smallpox were actually vaccinated people, and people who were not vaccinated were not, the people who got without vaccination got smallpox, the number was very, very low. So seeing that, and the repeated more vaccination epidemic started breaking just because after they started this incident, and then they stopped it at some point of time. But before they stopped it, many doctors actually joined it. So we all thought that some set of scientists understood the disease. They did a lot of experiment like today, and then finally they found a very good remedy, and then they started practicing. No, it is from some lady who was not a qualified. Seeing the folk medicine, they started practicing it, and then doctors took over at that point of time. They took over the practice, and then it was a huge business at that point of time. One side non-medical doctors were doing it, one side doctors were doing it, became like a huge economic shift in the practice of health. So then when they found out there's alarming rate of smallpox coming back again and again, more people die who are vaccinated, somehow people were like skeptical, okay, I'm not going to do it, it doesn't work anyway. They stopped doing it. At that point of time, and there was like some 16 to 20 years of gap, people were skeptical, they were not doing it. And the business went really down. It was like people were not ready to go. And that point of time, another person, like his name is, I think, Jenner. So what he does, many medical doctors in the author, they claim him Dr. Jenner. He is not a doctor by profession. In those days, people who have pharmacies, they gave a license. They are called as apothecary. So that means they can actually prescribe a medicine. Like in India, it's pretty much common, though legally we call it as you can't get prescribed drugs. If you know a medicine, if you go to a medical shop, even now people buy it. I've seen people buying it. So they were doing that same thing like I'm talking about in the 17th centuries. So he met a lady, some person who was actually milking cow, who works in a cow farm. So cows actually get a disease called as cowpox, okay? That is because of human dirt what they have that infects the nipple of the cow, and they get that pox, and it also spreads to human being slightly. So she told him at once like, hey, you know what, I got cowpox, so now I will never get smallpox in my life. And this person believed it and saw that as a huge opportunity when people have been not able to find an answer to it. Immediately what he did is, collected the blood sample of that cow which got cowpox, and he injected it to a 7 or 8 year old boy, and then he started claiming it doesn't happen, and there's no smallpox, this guy would never get it. And it again, many doctors joined it, and the surprising fact is nobody verified the data whether cowpox and smallpox, the disease, are same, the same virus. Till now there is no clear answer. So far I've been searching for years together. So they just assumed it, and they started again re-promoting this concept to everyone. So the funniest part here is the cowpox comes only to the milking cow. It doesn't come to the bull, it doesn't come to the calf. And nobody has given an explanation why these two animals doesn't get to only cow, and how can these both be same. Okay. Then they made it more refined and more refined and more refined. Even now for smallpox or BCG, I've seen some information where people say that it is still made in this form only, and they have distilled it, and that's what has been injected to inside our body. So it is not the same, the both are very different. And what happened is again the business starts booming, many people walk in for this thing. At some point of time again there was a lot of epidemics breaking in smallpox, many people died. When they did a statistical survey, they found out more people who vaccinated were actually killed in smallpox, whereas normal people who never did it, their numbers were very, very, very low. That's it. So it came to a where, it came to a revolution in England, in Britain, and they finally did a report called as commission. Usually when some big scandal or some scam happens, they do appoint a commission, right? They appoint the experts, and they will try to do it and to find and understand the root cause of it. Then they appoint it called as a Royal Commission. So that, about that Royal Commission, I'll talk in the next video, and we'll continue the vaccination series, and we'll see where it takes us, okay? So that is how the first part of vaccination, the history, the initial starting phase of it. And do share if you know any other information on it. The word vaccine itself came from the vaccinia, vaccicus, that is the Latin name of a cow. That's called vaccination. So I'll see you in the next video with some a continuation of this. What about, what did Royal Commission find out, and what happened there till today, what is the story on it? Okay, see you in the next video. Thank you.